Hi, I'm Neeta Mehta. I'm a food blogger. And today we are here with Rohan from NotionInk, who will, you know, answer a few of my questions about the product NotionInk that has come up with. So let's just quickly start. Hi, Rohan. This is Neeta.
Hey, hi.
So tell me about the product of NotionInk that it's recently come up with the 10 version, right?
Yes. Yeah. So this is a two-in-one. It's okay. A two-in-one because you can just attach it and make it a tablet, and then you can attach it back to actually make it a laptop.
Okay.
It's convertible and it's really handy. So that's it. So okay. In around 1 kilograms, you get computing power of a real PC.
Okay.
And when we say real PC, we are not talking about the gaming PCs, we're talking about the PC which actually make it productive. So you can carry it around, do your food blogging anywhere you want. You can take photographs of the food items and actually upload it. You do not need a wireless connection. You can add your SIM card or use an internal 3G. So yeah, so that's what it is. Actually, a real easy and handy mobile PC for everyone and all.
So, as you know, I did tell you that I mentioned I'm a food blogger. So we do move from city to city. You said this is portable. How is the battery life of it?
So it gives around 8 to 10 hours depending on how you're using it. If you switch on 3G and you're at a really bad signal, then it might drop down to 6 hours. But it will never disappoint you. And whenever you need it, the device is still going to be there. And that's why we have designed it.
Okay. So I also came to know about the pen that you have introduced right now. So can you give me a small gist about what exactly it is and whether it can work with other phones or other laptops, of, you know, the functionality kind of a thing?
So the stylus we have is, we call it Pro Pen.
Okay.
We call it Pro Pen because it's really professional and it's not tied to any device, which is one of the aims which we had, because if you tie it to a device and you have any other device, you'll not be able to get the same experience there.
True.
So we want to focus on stylus as compared to the stylus plus the device lock-in part. Now, this Pro Pen is actually really good for scribbling, drawing, sketching, taking notes. Not so very well for actually taking very finite, very small letter notes. It's not designed for that, because for that you actually need some sort of digitalizer on the back of the screen. But as long as you're not doing that, it will actually serve every single purpose. So if you're browsing on the internet, especially on the new edge browser which is there on Windows 10, you can actually take elements out from a web page and share with people. You can edit stuff. So if you're a blogger, this will actually help you write really fast, especially if you know shorthand. And if you're actually doing research, it will help you create a lot of content, copy content, paste content.
Okay.
One of the things which we actually wanted to do with this is so make it, as I said, make it compatible with different screens. There we realized that a lot of devices actually have different capacitance. They have a different capacitance, and the capacitance also changes as soon as you put any screen guard on top of it or tempered glass on top of it. Because capacitance is really the distance between where your touch points are there on the glass and the touch panel.
Okay.
So we actually designed this in such a way that you can actually rotate the tip.
Okay.
And as you rotate the tip, it comes out and the capacitance increases.
Okay.
And you actually rotate it back to reduce the capacitance.
Okay.
So not only this is useful if you are using a tempered glass, this is also useful if you're actually using it at a very slant angle. Because when you're actually reducing the angle, the amount of area in touch is that reduces, right? So you can actually do brush strokes really easy.
Okay.
So for painters, this is the best gift we can give them this Christmas.
So does this have an application that you need to install?
That's the best part. It's compatible with every operating system. You just need to have a touch panel on your device. So you do not need any application. Having said that, there are applications which makes best use of a stylus. Like Bamboo app is there. Microsoft OneNote is there. Because when you're writing, you need an application which can immediately do some sort of
curves
fixings.
Yeah.
Right. So there are a few applications which are really good. On iPad, they're really very beautiful application where you can actually use this.
So that's great to know that you don't have to have a headache of installing an app and then using it and getting it configured. So as a food blogger, what do you think this will be helpful for me as? Because, you know, we have a lot of pictures to connect. We always connect with pictures and visuals.
Yes.
So how useful is it going to be for me?
So I'll start with the visual, with the text part.
Mm-hmm.
Because you see a small device and you think, okay, how am I going to type on it? But I bet you actually take a real keyboard from a real laptop or even a black keyboard, and if you compare the size of the distance between Q and P, you will actually see they are just around 1 centimeter less as compared to original. So even the device is less, you will not feel that it's cramped. So while writing on this keyboard, it's quite possible that you will find it difficult to shift back on your original keyboard because the writing functionality is really good. Coming back to on the camera part, this has 2 megapixel. 2 megapixel might feel small as compared to 5 megapixel or 21 megapixels coming today. But what we're focused here is on this picture quality, even on that 2 megapixel, because the use case for this was more for the video.
Okay.
And this can already do 720p. So 720p is good enough for our interactions. Yeah. 1020, 1080, of course, it's a good to have, must have, but even on YouTube, you actually want to look at videos at 720p. Yeah, so that's where it fits. So the color reproduction is really good. And Windows 10 actually has done good work on the image processing part also.
Okay.
We are using OmniVision, which is used by Apple, Samsung, really all the good brands are using OmniVision also. And OmniVisions are known for their cameras.
Okay. So it's great to know, I mean, how did you actually come up with this particular design? I do know that you did do a lot of designing in your life. So what actually motivated you to get this particular design with the pen and everything, you know, because right now it is very accessible.
Yes.
You know, everybody would want something which is all in one for them and it's very handy. So tell me something about, you know, from where it exactly came up.
So when it touch came out around 2008-09, everyone thought that touch is all what we need and we'll not need anything else. But the problem is that as soon as the keyboard pops up on a screen, the amount of area left is very small. We can't really do anything there. Moreover, we need some sort of feedback to actually get from the device to know that we actually pressed something. Earlier devices used to hang a lot also, so if you press a space bar, you're waiting for the keyboard to react also. So those things are still there, which can be really fixed if you're using the hardware because the interfaces are really different. So till 2013, we were actually doing only touch devices, but we realized that we are not fixing the productivity problem, right? I am not making a device which can force me also to leave my laptop and depend on them. And we really want to do that. Create devices which can force us, anyone, to replace the laptop and start using these. For that, you have to have a keyboard.
Okay.
Now, not only you have to have a keyboard, you need to have some sort of mechanism where you can dock it and place it at some angle, right?
Yeah.
So those are the things which we learned, and these are possible for us to do because we have been learning over all our journey. It's not that we have started yesterday and we are going to China and bringing it. We are against those trading models which other companies have. It's really frustrating also because they just go there and bring stuff, and Chinese are really good in replicating stuff. So as soon as we came out, they would make the device in the next 3 months and you will see other competitors also coming out. But what they can't take out is the finite features or the very minute features which go in making this device really different. For example, the texture of the keyboard. I bet you touch any other keyboard with any other manufacturer and you'll not find this kind of stiffness, you'll not find this kind of feel on the keyboard also. Their keyboard will actually attract dust a lot. There's no way you can fix that, there's no way you can clean them.
Yeah.
This keyboard you can clean with a soft, warm, wet cloth. You can actually use a simple sellotape, paste it on top and take it out to actually take these small particles also away. Oh. So we've spent so much work on this. I'll tell you a very simple fact, right? Windows 8 disabled hibernation.
Yeah.
So all of these devices were touch only and you can actually do only sleep mode or you do a shutdown mode. Shutdown is definitely not good because you want to be on, you want the device to start as soon as possible. Sleep is not good because in Windows, sleep is connected to wireless and it consumes a lot of battery. And on these two in-ones, they have a keyboard which is little flexible. So if you close it and you press it, it will actually turn on.
Okay.
So that drains the battery a lot. So we actually, against Windows, we have got the hibernation back in the module. So now our devices can actually support hibernation. This is the only two-in-one which supports hibernation today.
Okay, that's lovely. So all you food bloggers out there, all the bloggers from the blogging world, I think this is something that you will need to have a look at, and I'm sure most of you will be interested in having one at your home. It was lovely talking to you and taking me through the journey of NotionInk. It's lovely meeting you.
Thanks a lot.